Hi family and welcome back to Doing Life with Pastor Donovan and Pastor Chantel.
It is great to be with you once again on this Wednesday afternoon and thank you for being with us.
Well family, today we're going to speak about the importance of just staying close to God.
Staying close to Jesus is the only way that we are going to be able to navigate through these end times. You know, we were talking about this not too long ago. We're talking about how important it is that we have Jesus in our lives.
Right.
And, you know, when Jesus was asked by his disciples, Lord, what is the signs of the end times? Jesus responded to them and he said one of these things that is very important to me. He said, in the last days, the love of many will grow cold.
Yes.
And that is one of the signs that we see in the world today. But I want to read you the portion of scripture in Matthew 24, which Jesus responds in full. And I want us to read the scripture because I want you to see that a lot of these things, in fact, all of these things,
is happening.
It's happening right now. We can see it all around us. But listen to what Jesus answers his disciples when they asked him to give them an idea of what this end times would look like. He says this, "Don't let anyone mislead you, for many will come in my name, claiming I am the Messiah. They will deceive many, and you will hear of wars and threats of wars. But don't panic. Yes, these things must take place, but the end won't follow immediately. Nations will go up against nations, and war, and kingdoms rather, against kingdoms. There will be famines and earthquakes in many parts of the world, but all of this is only the first part or the first of the birth pains, and with more to come. And then you will come arrested, persecuted, killed, and you will be hated all over the world because you are my followers. And many will turn away and will betray each other and hate each other. And many false prophets will appear and will deceive many people. Sin will be rampant everywhere and the love of many will grow cold." But listen to this. It says, "But he who endures till the end will be saved." He who endures till the end will be saved. And the good news of Jesus needs to be spread all over the world before the coming of the Lord.
That's right.
And so we want to speak to you today really about making sure that you stay close to Jesus.
Important.
We want to speak to you about the fact that the only way that we can navigate as Christians through this end times, which is clearly upon us, is to stay close to Him.
Yeah, and we were talking about looking beyond what we have last week and looking beyond what's going on in the world. And I think for us as people, it's so important that we just continue seeking the Lord's face and stay close to Him. And then we know that we will be ready if we stay in the fold. But the minute we're going to start wander off, and that is when our love for God will grow cold. And so it is important that we just stay close to Him. Seek His face constantly and know then all those things will matter to us.
Yeah. You know, in Matthew chapter 6, Jesus speaks about not being, or not worry about anything.
Yeah.
Verse 25, He says, "Do not worry about anything, what you're going to eat, what you're going to drink. For God knows that you need all these things." And then verse 33 says, "Seek first the kingdom of God and all His righteousness, and everything else will be added." And we want to appeal to you to, once again, as a child of God, remember to put the Lord first. To put Him first in your life. Because at the end of the day, everything else does not really matter. You know, the Bible tells us, what does it benefit a man if he gains the whole world, but if he loses his soul?
And we can see how things are changing around us, how the world is changing. But one thing is for certain, the Word of God never changes.
Never changes, yeah.
And this is what we need to hold on to. Because everything else changes, but God still remains the same. And it's so, He refers to the world of the pains, like a labor pains, mm-hmm. you know,
yeah.
what's going on in the world.
Mm-hmm.
And we know with labor pains, new birth is coming, new
yeah.
life is coming.
Yeah.
So it's a life with the Lord that is coming,
mm.
that is busy. All the things need to happen
mm-hmm.
for the Lord to come back.
Absolutely. And, you know, it is so certain that, it's like you were speaking about, there's very little things in life that you can be certain about.
Mm.
But you can be certain about the fact that
that's right.
that all of us mm. will leave this earth. All of us will die.
Mm.
And I know that
yeah.
is probably not a fun thought,
mm.
but it's a sobering one. We need to understand that, you know, our lives
mm.
matter. And as much as our lives matter to
mm.
us, it matters to God.
That's right.
It matters what we do with our lives.
Mm.
And so when
mm.
we look at the world and really the madness that's going on around
mm.
the world, you know, we can surely but
yeah.
look at the Word of God and say, you know what? Here it says, do not panic.
Yeah.
Do not worry. Do not worry about things that are happening around you.
Mm.
Because at the end of the day, these things will happen.
That's right.
But we know that the Lord
mm.
will continue to lead us and carry us
yeah.
through difficult
That's
times.
That's right. And He wants us to stay in the Word because, like you said, the end times is near. And that's why He's telling us about it, because He wants us to be ready.
Mm.
And that's why He's telling us all these things to prepare us
mm.
for it.
Mm.
But in that preparation, we need to prepare our hearts.
Yeah.
We need to stay in that close contact with the Lord,
mm.
in fellowship with Him, love the Lord. And so all these things that He's
yeah.
telling us, it's not in vain. He wants us to take note of it,
yeah.
you know, that we're not ignorant about these things, because it's going to happen,
mm.
but that we need to keep our eyes fixed on Him.
Yeah. And the only way that you and I can keep our eyes on the Lord,
mm.
we find the scripture in Matthew, where it speaks about abiding in the vine.
That's right.
And we know that in John it
mm.
is where it speaks about abiding in the vine.
Mm.
Where Jesus says, the only way that you can go through things is
mm.
if you abide in Me. And there's two ways that we abide in God, and that is to abide in His love
mm.
and abide in His Word. And it's so important that we are stable, you know, and we consistent
mm.
in the Word
right.
of God, because this is where you will find your strength.
That's right.
You know, the Word of God is where you will find your strength, your
mm.
wisdom, your guidance, everything else that you need
That's
to navigate
right.
through life is found
yeah.
in the Word of God.
You know, and we can see how the enemy, how the devil, is just keeping people's eyes so focused on what is going on in the world. And it keeps people even so busy in their lives,
mm.
you know. And sometimes it's good things, it's work, and it's your family and all those things, but it keeps people so occupied
mm.
with the worldly things that they neglect the important things.
Mm.
And that is to stay in fellowship
mm.
with other believers and to not neglect the gathering of the saints.
Mm.
And all of those things, it's important. We need to be in the house of the Lord.
Yeah.
If the Lord is coming, where is He going to find you? What is He going to find you
busy with?
Yeah.
Yeah. And so, you know, today we want to remind you of the words
mm.
again of Jesus.
Yeah.
He says, not everyone that says, Lord, Lord,
That's right.
will enter into the
yeah.
kingdom of God. So we understand and we know that this message and doing life
mm.
this week is probably one of those that we require self-reflection.
That's
we require to look into our own self.
Mm.
And we might not like what we find.
That's right.
We might have to shift priorities.
Mm.
We might have to up certain areas of our lives
mm.
and let go of certain things
that slows us down,
according to what Hebrews tells
yes.
us. And you're absolutely
mm.
right. Sometimes it is not necessarily sinful things that
mm.
slow us down. But the Bible says every weight,
mm.
everything that slows you down. And we were talking about how important it is that, you know, God takes priority over everything in our lives.
Right.
Because I love the question that you asked is when the Lord comes,
mm.
and it's not an if,
when.
It's when He comes, what is He going to find us busy with?
That's right.
Where is He going to find
That's
us?
Right.
And it's so important, you know, that we constantly stay in the presence and in the house of God
mm.
as well. Because in Hebrews chapter 10, where it speaks about do not neglect the gathering of the saints, the reason you do that is so that you look for every opportunity to encourage one another. And we need that.
That's right.
We need that today.
And we need to, you know, we just need to continue to seeking the Lord and spread the word of God to a dying world out there.
Yeah.
You know, we need to be the light and the soul to the world, because that we can take as many souls with us when the Lord is coming. You know, and that is the important, that is the message that we need to, that we need to proclaim this, you know?
Absolutely. And so, you know, the title of what we're speaking about is staying close to Jesus. But in order to stay close to Jesus, you must first have come to Jesus.
That's right.
And so we cannot stay close to the Lord if we have not accepted Him. You know, and in the book of Romans, chapter 10, verse 9, it reads as follows. It's 9 verse 10, apologies, 9 verse 10, I'm in the wrong place. 9 verse 10, it says, if you believe in your heart that Jesus is Lord, and confess with your mouth that He is, that He's raised from the dead, you will be saved. And then the next verse says, for it's with your heart one believes unto righteousness, with your mouth confession is made to salvation. And so it is so important that you accept Jesus. Jesus was asked a question one day by a Nicodemus. He was a young, rich ruler. You see, asked Jesus, what must I do to inherit the kingdom of God? And Jesus said, you must be born again. And he didn't firstly didn't understand what born again meant. But Jesus explained to him that you need to be born again by the Spirit, the Spirit of God. And that comes through the scripture that we've just read in the book of Romans. And so we today want to really take this opportunity just to pray this prayer with you. Because, you know, verse 10 says it's with your mouth confession is made unto salvation. And so there is no salvation without a confession. And so it's very important that we are able to make that confession, to speak that confession. And that is how you stay close to Jesus.
Yeah, that's right. And you know, family, there's, we know a lot of distraction is going to come. But we just continually be sensitive to the Holy Spirit of where the distractions come from, and you know where what it is holding you back from. And so just be sensitive to the voice of the Lord.
So what we're going to do now is we're going to ask you to pray with us. We're going to ask you to do some introspection, take a look at your life. For those of you perhaps have not received Jesus as your Lord and Savior, we want to lead you in a prayer of salvation and make this confession, make this commitment, and you know, just trust the Lord that He will carry through, because we are living in such dangerous times, and we are living in such end times, really, according to Matthew chapter 24, what we just read. There is nothing that I've just read now that we have not seen. We've seen earthquakes, we've seen wars, rumors of wars, we've seen lawlessness, sin abiding in the world. And all of these things are signs of the end times. And we want to pray this prayer with you. So let us close our eyes together. Let's pray this. Pray this and say this after me. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For dying on the cross.
For dying on the cross.
I accept. Jesus is. The Son of God.
The Son of God.
God raised Him from the dead.
God raised Him from the dead.
After three days.
And today.
As I accept Him. I'm alive in Christ.
I'm alive in Christ.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
A friend, if you've prayed that prayer, we want to congratulate you. Remember, this is the beginning of a journey. We want to really, we've had it impressed on our hearts that, you know, we do not have the luxury of time on our side anymore.
That's right.
Jesus is coming. What is He going to find us busy with? And that is why we are talking to you today. It's out of love, and we want you to live your best life. And we know that if the Lord tarries and you've got 20, 30, 40, 50 years to come, all right, if the Lord should tarry, it's going to be the best years of your life, because with Jesus, nothing is impossible.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Well, family, you know, keep your eyes fixed in the Lord. Look beyond what is going on in and around in your sphere of influence or of your life. And just, you know, persevere and don't give up. We know the end from the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
And we know if Jesus, the day that he comes back, we all going to go with him.
Absolutely.
Amen.
Amen. Well, we trust you're going to have a beautiful Wednesday and enjoy the rest of your day, but also enjoy the rest of your week. And remember, Jesus is Lord.
Wow, family, from our home to your home, we love you and we continue praying for you.